Hi, in case you noticed, the other guy who's usually here, he's not here. He, like, had a really slow morning, and then he tripped and fell, and then he's, like, not able to do it, so now I'm here. Sorry, you're gonna have to make do with me. What are you guys here for again? I forgot. Oh, did you guys just show up in Pittsburgh and we're like, I'm gonna sit around and watch people in carpets dance all day? I guess that's what they're here for. So, I guess we should get the show going. So, one more time. Hi, Anthocon! My name is, well, my name's usually Zeke, but I go by Haida sometimes, as you can see. I'm a good office yeen. At least I think I am. I don't know. But we are at Anthocon's dance competition. It's 8th or 9th or 10th annual one. We've been having one for so many years that I can't even remember. So, you guys ready? I said, are you guys ready? All right. Well, before we begin, a quick introduction of our lovely judging panel that we've got today. Up on stage, from my right to the left, we got T the Dragon. We have Strobes. We have Gale Frostbane. And last but definitely not least, we have Kato. And these four expert judges are gonna be, well, they're gonna be judging. What else can I say? So, why not we give them something to judge, but also to cheer for with your first competitor of the day, ladies and gentlefers, give it up for the Fierce Felines! Something fierce for sure. Audience, come on, y'all can make more noise than that. Yeah. We got a whole bunch of this kind of action coming up for you in the next 2 hours. You guys gotta make sure you're giving them the energy they deserve, because they're doing this all for you guys. But We'll leave it for our judges to provide expert commentary. Judges, we're just gonna keep things nice and simple. We're gonna have one judge for each act. So, if one of y'all would like to take it away with the commentary.
All right. Hi, kiddies. That was really, really fun. I'm glad that we started off with a group. I know you guys were definitely working hard on that choreo. For me, the first half, with the first song, it was really, really cute. And there were a couple of times where I think you might have missed a few cues, but you just kept going. You never really looked lost, which was nice. I have to say, though, the second half, way stronger. Like, when that thump, thump, thump hit and your chest pops, it was wonderful. Like, really, really wonderful. Like, I really would love to see more of that from you guys. So, honestly, for me, I thought that was really, really well done. Just clean some stuff up a little bit. I know it's always really hard when you're like, oh no, I just missed a cue, but just keep going because you guys were doing that. So excellent job, guys.
Give it up one more time for the Fierce Felines. Pretty kitty, pretty kitty, pretty kitties, pretty kitties. Ah, well, let's not stop the action, especially because we got so much more for you. So I need your help once again, audience, in helping me welcome to the stage. It's none other than Beta Monkey. Wake up this morning. I just rolled out of bed and landed in a puddle on the floor. And he can do that this early? Wow. That's why I'm not dancing and he is. But, judges, what did we think of that awesome performance?
Hi, Beta. How are you? Sorry, we don't have any bananas over here for you. Oh, no, come back. Come back. It's all right. It's all right. Could we get a medic?
Yeah, that was me this morning, too. See, Beta right. Understands.
So, Beta, I think the thing that always stands out to me about your dancing is that you're incredibly precise and deliberate with all of your moves, but you also are very good at knowing when to take risks. Overall, I thought it was fabulous. I think if I had any critiques at all, I would like to see you maybe just, like, totally go crazy for, like, 10 seconds. Like, not be as choreographed or as measured in your moves, and just to like, that would completely change the dynamic because you're so in control the whole time. And I think eventually I'm just waiting for you to go nuts, but overall this was fabulous. Good job.
Don't you mean go bananas? All right, awesome stuff by Beta Monkey. Whew. I gotta look at the next competitor, and, well, they seem really familiar to me. I mean, I've seen them before, and, you know, their name was, like, Jay or something like that, and they were all cool and stuff, but now they've stepped up to their next new form, and they're coming out on stage to perform for you as Kiro!
Keep her awake, give me a fright. I don't know what goes through her mind when she takes drugs. Stone, two damn phones, Babylon's can't crack the code. Used to sip out styrofoam, but figured I should stick to drugs. Backwoods, overload, don't like to smoke them swishers. If you hit my liquor store, it's 50 cents for single pokes.
Kiro, smoother than my peanut butter and a Nutella sandwich this morning. Man, I like that. Let's see how the judges like it too. One of our lovely judges would like to take the mic.
Oh, thank you. Hey, oh my gosh, you know these songs so well. I absolutely love, you are so, oh, hi. Hey there. you can tell, you've worked so hard. You know absolutely every hit, but I feel like delve deeper into these songs. There's definitely some other levels to these songs that you can definitely explore a little bit more that is gonna be absolutely perfect for you. I would love to see more of that. But I loved all, like, every hit. Those are strong, strong hits. You shook the entire stage. I loved it. Thank you.
Everyone, one more time for Kiro. Hey, that was still smooth as my peanut butter. Awesome stuff, awesome stuff. All right. Now the next one, I think we're gonna heat things up like a barbecue because, well, our next dancer, give it up, ladies and gentlemen, for Sirloin.
Outside in the waiting.
definitely feeling the heat from that one. That was also, like, I would say smoother than my peanut butter, but we'd be here all day making peanut butter references, so I'm gonna stop with those, and I'm gonna let the judges take it away. Judges, what do we think?
Hello, Sirloin. How are you? So, I really dig this methodical, contemporary style that you have going, and I love how clean and wide your movements are. But, when in certain songs, like the one that you have, when it gets more bombastic, I want to feel that energy flow through you and really explode so the audience really feel it, because, and then at the same time, just a little bit of work on the balance, but that's about it, because I really enjoyed it.
And I think the audience did too. Crowd, one more time for Sirloin. Woo! Now that's a piece of beef I'd eat any day. Anyhow, moving right along. Is it too early in the day for that? Because it ain't for me. It's 5 p.m. somewhere. It's all right, because we got our next competitor coming up real soon. And I want you to give a huge round of applause, performing as Maxwell, it's Zero!
My baby's a freak like me, and she knows just what I like. She carries all the keys to the places that no one dares to find. She won't tell nobody what goes on within these walls. If they talk, they probably tell you I'm not love.
Dang. That's all I gotta say. Judges, hopefully you got more to say than I do, because dang.
I have so much to say. My gosh. That was so good. You nailed this, like, cute, adorable, I'm not sure if mouse or rat, and rat? Lab rat? Lab rat. Okay. You nailed it. Because it was so cute, but also creepy, and you just,
Mom,
that was, what?
You're not supposed to call your kids creepy.
I love all my children, that was a little creepy. That was literally, like, just the way you moved in this suit was so reminiscent of how a rodent would move, and the fact that your big thwumpy tail and your huge legs were not, like, affecting you at all while you were dancing, and you were hitting so many beats with not only your upper body, but with your lower body, that was excellent. I would say, if anything, honestly, I'm not sure what to say, if anything, I would just say keep practicing and keep practicing, because I want to see you, especially in this suit out here, dancing so much more, because that was excellent. Excellent job.
Crowd, we agree? Yeah, I think we agree. Awesome stuff, Zero. All right. Next up, wow, we got a special one. We got a special one, and I'm gonna talk about this special one after they perform, but this is one that you definitely won't wanna miss. Coming to the stage, crowd, I want you to give the biggest round of applause you've ever given for Zapper!
Thank you.
Zapper. That was an electrifying performance. Oh, by the way, you dropped this, sweetie. Oh, Zapper, Zapper, over here. You okay? You dropped this, sweetie. You want me to hold it on for you? Okay, there you go. There we go. I want to say something really quickly about Zapper. I don't know if you noticed, but Zapper's a little vertically challenged. But it's okay. You know why? Because Zapper here is only 10 years old. And this sweet little thing can do that? Yeah, thanks for making me feel old. Zapper here, being 10 years old, this competition was apparently only like 13 and up, but whoever the idiot was that made that rule, well, he's not here now, is he? So, as you can see, the fandom has so much talent from all different places, all different shapes, sizes, ages, no matter where you come from. We got talent like this at AnthroCon. Give it up one more time for Zapper. All right, sweetie, let's see what the judges got for you.
Oh my gosh. Zapper, I'm blown away. I'm absolutely blown away. If I could do what you did at 10, my goodness, you made me feel old. So, your hits are so solid. They're so strong. I need you to work on your transitions in between those strong, strong hits. You know this song so well. I want you to also work on your speed. You're so strong, you're so fast. I want you to take it back a notch too. Just take it back, and I want you to make the crowd work for it. Don't give them all of it at once. I loved it. Oh my gosh, I cannot wait to see where you go with this. You have, oh my goodness.
I think the crowd agrees, yeah. Come here, Zapper, sweetie. You did an awesome job. You got a whole bunch of fans waiting for you back there, too. I mean, hey, if we got 10-year-olds doing that on stage, I mean, we definitely should get some of the young uns on here too next year. What do you think, crowd? Some more young uns? Yeah? Yeah? We'll talk about it later. But before we do get young uns on the stage, I want to get our next competitor up. Please welcome Kibo!
Boy.
Judges, save me, please. I can't even right now. I can't even.
Okay.
I've had too much to drink. I mean, to chug coffee and stuff. It's 5 p.m. somewhere, I said. Judges, right. What do we think?
Thanks, Haida. Wow, okay. I'm trying to come up with, something for you to work on, because honestly, the entire performance was awesome. And it's kind of like, it's like, sometimes with a performance like that, as it goes on, people tend to start doing the same things over and over. And I feel like any single time I was worried about that, you came up and just threw something out of nowhere that I wasn't expecting. So, I mean, you surprised me, your showmanship was amazing, you used the whole floor, you hammed it up. I don't know. I don't really have a critique right now. So, I thought you did.
I don't think we do either. I mean, when you can land in a splits like that in the middle of the stage, our opinions are invalid. One more time, everyone, for Kibo! I just got sympathy pains thinking about that. Oh, no, that's not happening anytime soon. What is happening soon, though, is our next competitor. So, crowd, give it up for Meet You! Like every dance move in the book just now from Meet You. Oh my goodness. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, stop whipping. No, don't do the T. Don't do the, don't. No, no, we're not doing the. You kids make me feel old. All right, judges, what do we think about that? I mean, that frankly, everything performance. There was so much in there, I didn't even know what to think. What do you think, judges?
Come here. You were great. I love it, man. Oh my God. So, one basic thing. There's only one thing that I want you to do, because I love how you took your time with some movements and like to do a little. There's a lot of versatility that I could see, especially in the middle. But one thing I want to say is that I want you to go more abstract, like try like not facing the audience for a little bit, and then you do stuff with your arms or over your knees or over your head, do a T pose, a headstand. I don't know, but yeah.
T, stop making your fans do the exorcism for you.
Excuse me here. But yeah, really good. Nice.
One more time for Meet You. Yeah. Ooh, we got a lot of action still going up. I don't even know how much throat I got left. I gotta have some more cough drops later. But next up to the stage, definitely a veteran of this competition for sure. I want you to make a whole bunch of noise for Saya!
Thank you.
Ooh, Saya, you slaying. You slaying indeed. Saya, you want this back? Here you go. Where'd you find this anyways? Hey, this looks like my bedcloth. What? I was chewing on this earlier. Where'd you find it? Do I want to know? Maybe? No? Is another question for the universe that won't be answered. Along with 1,000 other things about yin behavior, but we don't need to know about that. What we would like to know, though, is our judges. What do y'all think about Saya?
Oh, Saya. I think one of the biggest reasons that I love every time that you come out to perform is that you're not just coming out to do a dance performance, you're coming out to completely embody a character and present that character to the audience and have the audience then connect with that character, and you make the performance so much stronger because of that. Because you're an excellent, excellent dancer, and to then be able to absolutely nail a character on top of that, I mean, I think the audience would agree with me that you are dang good at that. So like,
woo! One more time for Saya.
Excellent job.
Hey. Oh, I threw that bedcloth back on the bed. Don't worry, you can find it there. Y'all good? Y'all good? Oh. You're taking it slow. It's all good. Woo! All right. Apparently, this next intro has to be like the greatest intro of all time. You know, like, so I gotta like all this dance call, but I'm really happy for it. I'm gonna let y'all finish. But we got the greatest intro of all time coming up right now. Everyone, give it up for Prism! Giving us something fresh. I like it. That made me feel all like good and cheery on the inside, and like, you know, all good and cheery on the inside and stuff like that. I don't know. I almost saw Prism go off the stage. Are you okay, sweetie? Okay. Just want to make sure. All right, judges.
That was adorable. Oh my gosh, such a feel good song.
Totes adorbs.
It was a totes adorbs. I obviously am a fan of all things ballet and classical, and I loved it. Your execution is so amazing. You have such control over your body. Guys, like, ballet is hard. It's so tiring. And I thought we started to wane towards the end. I understand keeping that control is very, very hard. But I thought all of you had such a wide variety of moves that you used for this entire song. I absolutely loved it. Great, great job.
Awesome stuff, Prism. Woo-hoo-wee. All right. Now, we got another veteran of this stage coming back on here. And trust us when we say this is one that you're going to need all your attention for, because these details that he's about to give you, you ain't ever going to see anything like it on this stage. So, crowd, a huge round of applause for Dushep! set and match, and man, you just killed all of the details. You're no longer Dushep, you're Details Chef to me now. Ugh, I have a feeling that Daddy Strobes, you might want to check out your son.
Oh my gosh, I love tennis.
I know, me too. Oh, yeah, did you realize that those were all tennis sounds he was dancing to just now?
Is that song called the tennis song? Is it just like called tennis?
I want to do one with golf next time. Can we just get like a whole bunch of swings and fours?
We're just going to continue to give Dushep like sports suggestions.
Sports
for every sports for every
chip.
Performance.
Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun, sports chip.
I mean, with reference to, because nobody's really brought this up so far, is song choice can be very, very, very important when you're trying to entertain a crowd of however many people are out here. And that song was epic. And I want to emphasize that it's an insanely good match for your dance style because you have a very, I'm trying to say awkward, but different, very original. This performance is definitely going to stand out because it was insanely original, just not in terms of song choice, but in terms of your dance. Again, I'm kind of stuck. I don't really have too many critiques to give. I think there were a couple of parts where, just because execution is one of your strong points, where it maybe could have been like slightly better, but again, you had moments where you nailed the song, where you kind of like drifted away from the beat and then came back really strong, and again, I thought it was fabulous.
Yeah, I bet the crowd did too. Didn't you, crowd? Yeah. Next time on Sports Chip, we got the golf song coming up. There we go. We got that four coming in. Audie, get on that. We'll remix it later. Woo! So, I think we have a showcase coming up next, don't we? A showcase, judges? I believe one of you is doing a showcase. Is that you? Is that you, Kato? Is that you? All right, Kato. Well, everyone, we gotta give our performers a little break and let our judges show you why exactly they're behind that table. So, everyone, Kato! Thank you so kindly, oh, you lovely, sweet thing, you. Woo. Well, now that we've given our competitors back there a little bit of a break, it's time to bring the next one out. What do you think, crowd? Next one? Next one? Yeah, well, help me bring out the next one with a huge round of applause. It's Monty Shep.
It's so lonely on the east side. I don't give a fuck, I keep it real, I'm not gonna let let it slide. Now she see me up, she let me want me to beside. Oski going dumb, hopped in the car, he said he down to ride. You a little pup, stop playing tough, ain't made no sacrifice. Yeah, smoking cookie for my appetite. I don't trust nobody, people talking, then be telling lies. We just wanna win and shock them all and catch them by surprise. I was tossed it down until we up and then we all rise. Yeah, but don't stick to the G code. Ballin' on my haters, I think that I'm stuck in beast mode. Make it through the foul, run to the line and make the free throw. I think that I'm D-Rose, do them like I'm Debo. Ayy, but I like to fade away. I got these diamonds on me, and these all in my face. And you wanna be a star, and you wanna win the race. But you cannot ride with me, cause I was gone on a chase. Nowadays, I'm too cool for a girlfriend. Nowadays, I don't know when the world spins. Live your life like we die when the world ends. It feels alright every time we break a sin.
Nowadays, it's not the same. Life switched lanes, now these look strange. And I lost my grip on the world and bliss. It's uh-oh, it's uh-oh.
All right, Monty Ship. Giving us that attitude for sure. Judges, what do we think of that attitude right there?
I'm still alive. Hi. So, Monty, that was a really decent performance. I noticed that on the second half you really went harder in terms of execution, and I want to see that throughout your whole performance. And I also want you to try more stuff with the legs, shoulders, shoulders and maybe twisting and stuff like that. Otherwise, you did a really decent job. You have a really good foundation. Thank you.
Woo! One more time, crowd. Show some love for Monty. You're a good boy. Yes, you are. You're a good boy. Woo! Speaking of good boys, we got another one coming up for you on stage, and he's definitely been making headway throughout the dance comp scene in the Midwest and the East Coast, and now he's here at Anthrocon to perform for you. It's Seth Gladiator! About recovering in style. Yeah, nothing ever happened. It's okay, we'll fix it in post, crowd. Y'all good, Seth? Just need a moment. Do you need an adult? No? It's okay, we don't got one. Oh, no, I'm not an adult, I'm a yeen. There's a difference. Woo.
Oh my goodness, Seth. I love every single time that you dance. Every single time that you dance, you make me so happy.
Aww.
And it is because you just come out here with an unimaginable amount of energy. Like, you kept the energy levels up the entire time to the point where when you lost a foot paw, you thought to yourself, oh, let me just incorporate it into my dance to put it back on. And like, that is... It is so clear that you choose these like high energy songs because you're so good at that and you come out here with a choreo and everything, but even in the moment when something like that happens, it proves just how creative and good of a dancer you are that you can just on the spot make that up and make that work. So like, absolutely incredible job, Seth. I'm so proud of you.
Yeah, top shelf stuff. Seth Gladiator, everyone. Woo! I'll see you later back there, buddy. All right, we got another familiar face coming up on stage. He's pretty much brought every kind of feel up here on stage, from feel feels to happy feels to blue feels. Yeah, he'll make you feel blue because it's none other than Aoi! Bringing us back to the disco era. Woo, Aoi. That's my personal favorite. I'm biased, but you're a good pupper. Yes, you are. Yeah, you're a good pupper. Yes, you are. All right, judges, what are we thinking about Aoi bringing back the disco era?
Oh my gosh, I love throwbacks. Like, especially when we can take, like, a song that I know I grew up on, I know everybody loves, and kind of bring it into this era. That is so important to me, like kind of keeping, you know, our roots, right? Like, it's amazing. You're so theatrical with everything that you do. Everybody I know had a great time with that dance. You definitely brought the entire crowd into it. I loved it. It was absolutely fantastic. So much energy. Thank you, baby.
Woo! One more time for Aoi. Mwah, mwah, mwah. All right, what a bouncy dog. I gotta be bouncy like that too. All right, next up, I want you to give another huge round of applause for another familiar face. Give it up for Sheila. Oh man, Sheila had us all like just headbanging back there. That was hype. Oh man, Sheila, putting in that work. Woo! Judges, we want to hear what you think.
All right, so again. Okay. It was a fanny pack. Again. Are we good? Okay, we good. Again, amazing song choices for your suit and character, and you do an incredible job of portraying that just like creepy, menacing vibe. Continue to do that, please. Just like not at me. Maybe at me.
But it's so fun when it does it.
It's so fun. No, yeah. Don't go under the table, please. No.
Can we not have what happened last year, please?
I think if I had a critique, I would say I would like to see a little bit more variation and exploration, because you have a lot of like arm movements, like you like to use a lot of angles and stuff like that. Continue to explore that, and you'll come up with some really new concepts that'll add a lot more dynamic to your routines.
Yeah, Sheila, give it up one more time. Bring us that monster vibe. Oh, we're gonna do floors right now again. We're gonna do floors. Oh, you beat me already, you win. All right, let's keep it moving. Next up, we got another pretty big, stumpy, powerful beast coming up on stage, and I know that they're gonna give you an awesome performance. So everyone, let's hear it for Raze!
Thank you.
attitude, swagger, all of the above, all over Ray's. He definitely giving us a show. Judges.
Ray's Razé. I love the energy that you put forth, like this force of nature that you are. I mean, look at him. I mean, he's intense, but I will say that I want to see more variation with your arms. There's this thing that dancers do, me included, that it's like this involuntary thing, and sometimes we don't even think about it. And I just want to see more in-depth our movements from that in that regard. Otherwise, great performance. Thank you.
Yeah, one more time for Ray's, everybody. Woo! Oh, even comes with a souvenir, too. Yeah. Don't ask. Just don't ask about that. We had this thing where I was trying to get a fan club for like the guy that was supposed to run the dance competition, and he wanted to do that, and we thought it was all idiotic. Now apparently he's like King Tut of the furries right now. It's really weird. Don't ask. But what I will do is I'm going to bring up the next performers, and they seem to know my Starbucks Rewards bank account or how much balance I have left, because they are $7 left on the card. Did they get it right as well? That was on point. All right, how do we feel about my Starbucks Rewards card?
Can we have another one afterwards?
That costs money. Do I look like
I feel invigorated. I feel like I just got a large iced coffee.
Nice. Oh, now I want one. Darn. Let's all go for that later.
All right, so mad props to some of those audio clips, especially in the beginning, because that was absolutely hilarious. You guys, execution-wise, you were very, very, very on point. Super good, super enjoyable, and you were very in sync, too, which is very hard to do with group performances when you can't even see the person in your peripheral vision. If I had to work on anything, I would say maybe add a little more complexity. I think as you went on with your routine, it was very like 1, 2, 3, 4, left, right. It was a little bit predictable in that sense. So as you go on, more complexity, keep up with the execution, and good job.
Yeah, awesome job indeed. We ain't got no audio troubles whatsoever. We got $7 left on the card. That's all we need. I mean, I need more for that iced coffee if I'm buying for everyone. Apparently, all of them want iced coffees now. Dad Yina's gotta go to work. But before we get all that iced coffee for the dancers back there, let's get another dancer on stage. So, coming up on stage, everyone, let's give it up for Laguna! Thank you.
and felt the part. I'm kicking all the sheets away. Oh, I'm jumping off a sinking ship. I guess I should've read the stars. I would've known that it would end like this. Oh, you never made me decent. Oh, you never made me strong. Oh, you never let me finish. No, you never. Down a dead end street till I let another dragon fly. Gonna strip another off her feet. Oh, I'm tripping off a sinking ship. Guess I should have read the stars. I would have known that it wouldn't like this. Oh, you never made me decent. Oh, you never made me strong. Oh, you never let me finish. No, you never.
Laguna, bringing all that colorful flavor in more ways than one on the stage. Whew. All right, what do our judges got to say about that?
Yes, Queen,
that is appropriate.
You can have whatever you want. You are, oh, Laguna. To see how you have just grown as a dancer is absolutely, you're too cute, is absolutely amazing, like seriously. I just having watched you just grow from, you know, you getting into this and being like, I love dance, to just killing it. I'll never forget how incredible you were at Pine Fur Con, and it was there and here that it is so clear that you are so good at footwork, like, and you use your whole body the entire time. To me, that was such a cleanly executed choreo, and I know that you choreo like crazy, so absolutely excellent job. I mean, if I would work on anything, it would just be, there seemed to be a small lull in the middle, but other than that, that was so clean, and I just wanna keep seeing you get out here and dance, because, I mean, I'm just so proud of you getting to the Anthrocon finals already. You just keep dancing and keep dancing, because you are going to blow people away. Am I right, audience?
Yeah!
They're
gonna keep
job.
On dancing, and we're gonna keep on cheering. One more time, everyone, Laguna! Awesome stuff, honey. All right, coming up on stage next, we got something of a small package, big attitude sort of performance, and let me tell you, she's definitely gonna bring that attitude. Cause coming up on stage, it's Lazuli!
Sugar, spice, and everything nice. These were the ingredients chosen to create the perfect little girl. But Professor Utonium accidentally added an extra ingredient to the concoction. Chemical X.
Say low, you can f*** with me if you wanted to. These expensive, these is red bottoms, these is bloody shoes. Hit the score, I can get them both, I don't want the tools. And I'm quick, cutting off, so don't get comfortable. Look, I make money move. If I see you now and speak, that means I don't f*** with you. I'm a boss to a worker, bitch, I make money move.
You got that milk money. I got that, I got that, I
Hey, she's got more of that milk money. She's got that swagger.
I love you.
Oh, we all love you too, Brenda. All right, judges, let's hear some comments about that swagger.
That, I loved it. Oh my gosh, this is my first time actually seeing you perform live. I loved you. That was all, you're cute and fluffy, but so strong and terrifying at the same time. That was amazing. I love every time I found myself starting to want something. Oh, I would need some levels. Bam, it happened. Oh, it's starting to get a little bit soft. Bam, you changed the music on me. Like, everything I started to want, you delivered within, like, 0.5 seconds. That was absolutely amazing. I absolutely loved it. I can't say enough. I cannot. Thank you so, so much.
I knew you were gonna do that. I knew it. I saw that. You wanna do it together? You wanna do it together? Ready? Ready? One, two, three. Audie, I thought you loved me. All right, well, we'll figure it out.
Wrong. You know the rules.
Por qué? All right, well, we got coming up on the stage next. Ooh, this one's definitely gonna need some of what you just did there, which was drop us in the shadow, because we got coming up on the stage, we got Shade.
Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. Make him the cutest that I've ever seen. Give him two lips like roses and clover. Then tell him that his lonesome nights are over.
If you make a splash like Pippin, that's nothing.
Splash.
Everybody call me Big Pimpin. No, I ain't bluffing. I'm with your mom in the kitchen, making blueberry muffins. It must be Thanksgiving, 'cause you hooked all the stuffing. Mr. Clean, baby, why you flow so mean? Mr. Clean, pull up with my whole damn team.
By the time you hear the next pop, the folk shall be within you.
And I'm thinking, damn, if these walls could talk.
Shade. Throwing us surprises every step of the way. Wow. Yeah, T?
Yeah.
You got this, boy?
Yes, I do. Wow. Haida. Wow.
Hi.
Shade, great moves. Keep it up. Honestly, I really like your performance. I love the character that you brought on, and I love Mr. Sandman, I love that song so much. All I want is from the second half of your performance, I wanted just a little bit more energy and more tightness. But otherwise, you did a really good job. Thank you.
Woo! One more time for Shane. All right. Next up, not to be confused with the performer we just saw, but they got a similar name, but... Oh, I betcha they're gonna give you an awesome performance just as well. So please, crowd, let's welcome to the stage, Slade!
Dead.
now. What's it made of?
Hey, Slade, Slade, did you lose your head?
No, it's not mine anymore.
Oh, it's not yours anymore. Anyways, all right. Judges, what did we think about that?
Hello, Slade.
Oh, Dr. Gale.
Oh, thank you, darling. Well, now I'm not going to critique you. seriously, I mean, having seen you in Four Words yesterday and just seeing the clear improvement there, it's very even Haida's playing with your other head. It's very clear that you are just working. You are putting in work and you are putting in effort and you are just coming out here, putting on a full-on performance that has something to do with the con theme, which a lot of you have done this year, which I am so hype about because I would love to see that more at cons. And I love that. I want you to keep pushing yourself. Keep pushing yourself to get out of your comfort zone, because I see it. Every now and then there was maybe a lull in the song or something like that, but seriously, that was excellent. And I want to see that improvement continue, and I want to see you continue to come out here and kill it. Maybe not kill things every time that you come out here, even though that was like also you. I don't know, just stop killing things.
Yeah,
but
don't kill things.
Keep
That's
killing
not nice.
The floor, because you did amazing.
Yeah, what Mama Gail said. One more time for Slade. Yeah, I don't know if y'all caught that brief glimpse of the N sign being killed as well, that poor N. It'll rest in signs, unfortunately. I hope it's okay. It looks okay. It's still Anthrocon. It's not like Athrocon. All right, still looks good. All right, well, we got a pair of performances left. We're actually coming towards the tail end of the competition, but nonetheless, we still got at least a pair of performances left for you. So let's get the first of that pair on stage. It's Major the Galaxy Wolf.
Just imagine the trip to a wonderful land of candy and jam. An ice cream.
I got a hit that string, you better watch it. Whip, I've got that attack with a full clip. I got the whip, got the pigeon that I keep undercover. All up in the cup, just to live it up. See this dope cold face, try to knock it. I keep it tapped and I walk on the rocket. I got a beat in it.
Mazer, the Galaxy Wolf. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Definitely putting in work. Oh, look at you. You're all cosmic and stuff. And you have glitter. Now I have glitter on my hands and this won't wash off. There we go. I'll return the glitter to you. The cosmos are now fully aligned. No, no, Elgato, no, gross. No, I just had this dry clean. No, I don't want to be a glittery hyena. Glitter hyenas are like, is that a contagious thing? Yeah, I think so now. Glitter hyenas, I just created a new species. It's gonna pop up on FA in an hour. All right, aside from glitter yeens, what about our judges? What did you think?
You look so pretty with that glitter on your hide.
Dad.
All right, so two things really stuck out to me. You had like a head and then shoulder isolation, and then you kind of went down to your hips and came back up with it. That was probably like the coolest part of the performance. You were very solid with that, and I feel like I want to see you do more isolations like that because you didn't do many of them, but when you did, they were very clean. So keep doing that. Also, hips. Anytime your hips were going back and forth, you seemed totally in your element. More of that as well. I think if I had a critique, I would probably say that I would like to see you exude a little more energy because the song was very, very upbeat. You have the horns going and like the heavy drums, and I want to see you really like throw yourself into it a little bit more. But otherwise, good job.
Woo, an awesome job indeed. Let's go, Major the Galaxy Wolf. All right, we'll see you real soon, sweetie. All right. Well, like I said, there was only a pair of performances left now, and we're down to the last one, unfortunately. But crowd, I want to hear you guys. I haven't heard from you in a while. You enjoying the show so far? Yeah, Anthrocon's dance content is always fun. It's always really, really high level as well. I'll tell you right now, we had over 90 competitors in the beginning. The preliminaries had 90 competitors. All of them came up on stage. They left all of their talent, all of their energy and passion on the stage. And we had 22 finalists just now performing for you guys. And again, all of it is for you. All of it's for your entertainment. These guys, they practice months. They practice even for an entire year, sometimes more than that, just to make it onto the stage for all of you. So I want to hear another round of applause for every single dancer that's back there. Oh, yeah. But like I said, we got one more performance coming up for you right now. It's another judge showcase because, well, our judges, they earned their spot up here, and a lot of them you've seen in the past performances as well. So our second judge showcase, please help me welcome to the stage, T the Dragon!
I ain't with it, had a swerve. I ain't with it, had a swerve. I ain't with it, had a swerve. I screw. I ain't with it, had a swerve. I ain't with it, had a swerve. I ain't with it, had a swerve. I screw. I ain't with it, had a swerve. I ain't with it, had a swerve. I ain't with it, had a swerve. I screw. I ain't with it, had a swerve. I ain't with it, had a swerve. I ain't with it, had a swerve. I screw.
Dragon. Yeah. Giving us that T-style, as we call it, the T-style. You see, if you see any one of the kids out there going like this, that's the T fan club. I don't know how it all started. Is it a T fan club? Is that the official thing now? Yeah, I don't know. T doesn't know. T's just like, I just swagged on all of y'all, so I don't really care. Well, like I said, that was the last performance that we got so far. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get all the dancers to come back on stage and just mosh around, you know, pose for photos, you know, basically just do their thing. So we're gonna grab the top three scores and then we'll be back with your results for this year's dance competition. So, dancers, let's start getting you guys back on stage. Crowd, make some noise for all the dancers. All right, don't go anywhere yet. We're gonna be back in just a few minutes with your top three results for this year's dance competition. Don't go away. Oh, and Adi, drop some heat for us, please.
Get down, 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 down,
All right, I think we have our results. All right, dancers, if y'all wanna back up from the front of the stage, $7 left on the card, Shade, Sheila. If all y'all wanna back up from the front of the stage, I don't want you accidentally falling over when you get so excited or someone like runs past you or something. Here we go, we want all of our furry friends to stay safe during the con. Ah, we have reached the end of the dance competition. Crowd, one more time, how do you feel? All of these dancers up here, all of them putting out everything that they love, all their passion, all their commitment on this stage for you again. But it's not just the dancers. This whole show takes so much. It really does. From the people that are backstage to the front to those running around. You know, this is a huge team that puts on a production that, honestly, I'm biased, but it's like the best one there is, seriously. And not only that, we're also on time, so yay, being on time and being responsible. Yeah, it's a little in-joke, furry's always late, yeah. But I do want to give at least a couple of very, very important mentions to the people that do make this happen. So, first and foremost, can we get a huge round of applause for our AV team at AnthroCon for making everything here possible? All the sounds, all the sights, everything in between. Nothing is possible without these guys putting it all together just for you. Can I get another round of applause for my backstage managers, Nemesis, Night Dragon, Zephyr, Humphrey? These four gentlemen made sure that none of these guys here had any boo-boos or falls or slip-ups backstage, that everything was all smooth and all that good stuff. And why not for my judges as well? T-Dragon, Strobe, Scale Frostbane, and Kato. Judging is no easy job, let me tell you. Especially when you got this much talent on stage, everyone's a winner. Really, at the end of the day, not just these finalists, but anyone who comes up on the stage and just tries. You go to the preliminaries, you try in Floor Wars. Oh yeah, by the way, anyone watch that last night? Floor Wars? Yeah. A lot of these people here, you saw them in Floor Wars and now they're up here again. So extra props for that. But it's a huge performance production and, well, without any of these people on this stage or back there, none of this would happen. But enough with all that flattering talk. You guys want to find out who took this year's top three, don't ya? Don't ya? Yeah, all right. So, can I get a drum roll going on, please? All right. Third place in this year's dance competition. Give it up for AOE! Come up here to the front, AOE. Come on up to the front. All right, up here, AOE. We got our mama Kato over here. She's got something special for you. She's got a customized acrylic plaque from Fizz Otter, I believe, is who makes these plaques. Let's show that for the camera really quickly. I'm just gonna show that off for the camera. There we go. It's a mummy. Thank you very much for coming, ladies and gentlemen. No. I'm sorry, AOE, you get the consolation prize now, a cracked iPhone screen. All right. So, that's third place. Without that happening, we'll edit that out later. But let's get another drum roll so we can find out who's second. Ah, whoa, this is a good workout. Leg day every day. Woo! Second place, we got Dushep! Woo, Dushep, hitting us with those tennis songs. Dushep's gonna be back with SportsCenter next year. All right, Mama Gail's got your plaque, and I'm not gonna touch this one. I don't want him to get a cracked iPhone screen. There we go. Mama Gail's proud of you. Mama Gail's very proud. All right. But there's only one thing left to find out. Who took the top spot in this year's dance competition? You guys ready? Let's get another drum roll. Taking home the top spot for Anthrocon 2018's Fursuit Dance Competition. Give it up for Kibo! An absolutely wonderful performance by Kibo, basically defying all odds and expectations. And yet, you get your plaque from last year's winner, Daddy Strobes, as well. It's like passing on the torch, basically. Woo! So, we got our top three winners over here. We got all of our dancers over here. Dancers, come up to the front now. Come up to the front. Let's let everyone see your beautiful faces. What's happening? What's happening? No.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up to Zeke for setting this whole thing up. Give him a huge round of applause for setting this whole thing and getting this all together. You make us blush, we make you blush. Don't even think you get out of this.
Por qué? All right. Well, I ain't really got anything else to say. Our dancers up here, they look pretty. Our judges are pretty much ready to get off the stage. They're done working with me. So, on behalf of all the dancers up here, on behalf of everyone that made this possible, thank you for coming out to Anthrocon's dance competition, and we hope you enjoyed the show. Yes! Chico, yes!